Good day and welcome to Cognos Analytics Quick Bites with LPA, our bite-sized chunks of big functionality. Today's Modeling 101 session is going to be on working with relationships. If you haven't seen the other videos, driving modeling with intent or Modeling 101 creating merge tables, you might want to watch those first. If not, go ahead and join us. I'll tell you what we've done. We built an intent-driven model. We took five product-related tables and merged them into a single table called products. And here we have our model at that point. We noticed that the five tables are joined to my order details, and my products merge table doesn't have a relationship. So let's work a little bit with these relationships. If I left-click on the relationship, I'm able to see what it's all about visually, tell me a little bit about the fields, as well as whether it's an inner join, a left join, etc. If I am right-clicking on that relationship line, I have the ability to edit it, see it as a query information, or remove it. In this case, I'm going to remove this relationship between the currently hidden products tables that are really the source behind this merged products plural that is what my users are going to work with. In order to create a new relationship, I'm going to click on the products table and hold down control and click on order details. I could have also control clicked over here in the data module pane on the left side. Right clicking the object, I have an option to create a new relationship, and I will. Into the new relationship, create relationship window, I see table one is products, table two is order details, and I see that I have a common product number between the two of them. As I click on a field, I do get a preview over here on the left for the left table and on the right for the right table. This preview intended to give me a good feel that I've got the right data types. If I click on a field that doesn't seem to match, it's kind of going to tell me that I might have a little bit of something that I need to investigate. In this case, product number to product number is a sound relationship. I'll go ahead and choose match, at which point I need to turn my attention to the bottom left, which is the sprockets. I'm going to click here and see what relationship type, cardinality, or optimization options I want to select for this relationship. If you have any doubts, you can hover over the eye, click on it, and it'll tell you a little bit about what you're doing as it relates to those joins. Similarly for the cardinality and the optimization options. There's a good amount of reading here to do if you're not sure about those optimizations, but if you use them correctly, you'll see that there's a significant performance improvement in your subsequent reports. So in this case, I have a good data warehouse that is built exactly to spec. So I'm going to choose this inner join style relationship because I know I'm not going to drop any records. The cardinality was selected was one to many, saying that if you look, I've got each row in table one, products has one or more matching records in table two, order details. I am okay with leaving that. My option for optimization was currently defaulted to no filtering. I can think about that for a moment. Unique values works really well if I've got a fine number, maybe 20 or less, realistically, unique values over here on the left side. The range of values will give you that, if my product numbers are between 10 and 2000, it'll do a subquery or a between expression in this case, sorry, that will tell me between 10 and 2000. In the case of this though, since I don't have a one-to-one relationship, we're going to go ahead and look at maybe perhaps using unique values in a subquery. In this case, the subquery will return my unique values and optimize my performance. This choice is a personal choice. You think about it, you think about the performance you're looking to get, make that choice dependent on your feel about it. If you are in any concern or you have any doubts about it, go ahead and click no filtering and that will be just fine. It's not like you're going to experience any errors if you choose no filtering, but it is an option to give you a little better performance. We then will preview our records, and you see our sort of fuchsia here table on the left, table one, our sort of jade table, that's my color language right there. On the right, we can see we're looking for things like Cartesian products. We want to make sure that we don't have any crazy repeats here. I look at the data, I feel pretty good about it, and I'm going to go ahead down here and choose OK. And now my product table is joined into my order details. Order details exists on the many side of its relationship, so that's telling me that's going to function a little bit like a fact table, and that's exactly how I want it to be. These relationships can be built, they can be modified the same way. If I go into an existing relationship and right click it and choose edit, you'll see I've got the same type of screen. It's just I've already got a match column. So let's go ahead, click there, and we can see that branch code on the left matches sales branch code on the right. I feel good about that relationship. If I needed to change it, I absolutely could here. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and cancel out and make zero changes. Thank you for joining us for today's Cognos Analytics Quick Bite with LPA Modeling 101, and we'll be back for lots more. So check us out here again in the future. Have a wonderful day.